Hi, my name is Umar and today we will be doing a comparison and review of Toyota Corolla Altis Grande. So let's start. Our website www.bamwheels.com is live now. You can check the website out to know my detailed opinion about these cars. Also, our Instagram page is there. It's Instagram/BamWheels. You can check it out and you can follow us on Instagram to see what are the cars that we'll be reviewing in future. And if there is a car that gets more likes than others, then there's a higher probability of that car being reviewed before others. Apart from that, on the website, the shirt that I'm wearing, this shirt and other car theme related shirts are available for sale. So you can check that out to see if there is a shirt that you like and you'd like to buy. These cars, like this 11th generation Toyota Corolla, was first introduced in 2014. And this particular design face of the car stayed till 2017. After 2017, the car got this major facelift in 2017. And this is the one that is available now. So I will show you the differences between these two cars, as well as I'll do a review of the cars, and then we will take it for a road drive to see how it drives. This car is powered with an 1800cc petrol engine and a CVT transmission. So let's see the features and then we'll take the car for a road drive and see how they drive. So first of all, let me quickly show you the things that made the previous Grande unique car, and then we will look at the differences in the two.
Rain sensor, climate control air conditioner, front camera, Android based navigation system, sunroof, leather seats, rear reclining seats, cruise control, Triptronic gearbox with pedal shifters.
First thing is a similarity between the two, which is the remote unlock retracting of the mirrors. So if I unlock the old car, the mirrors will retract themselves, and the same is with the new one as well. This is like the first difference of key. So this is the key of the old one, which has a lock, unlock, and a cup opening button, and this is a jackknife key, as you can see. The new car comes with a push start feature. So this one has an alarm button, which is an extra button. That they are the same buttons on the back. Both the keys have Toyota's logo, and from this one, if you want to take a conventional key out, this is how you take it out. Both the cars have a difference of alloy rims, and on top of that, the old one came with Eurostar tires while the new one comes with Yokohama tires. The old one came with this bumper style, while the new one and the lights, as you can see, this is the grill of the old one, and this is the design with the new one. This comes with DRLs as well. The bumper and the radiator, they are all changed in this one. If you look at the rear of the car, they both have a different light, and the garnish piece above the number plate, that is also of a different style between these two. So when coming to the old one, the dashboard design is different between the two, plus you get a different navigation system. The climate control design is also different. In the old one, you have all these blank switches, and over here, if you look, you have blank switches. This one comes with a conventional key, and the steering wheel and the speedometer is the same. Rest of the car is almost the same. The new car has the feature of smart lock. So if the car is unlocked and you have the key with you, you just need to put your finger over here and the car will be locked. So when we come to the new one, first thing that you see is this push start button. Let me just start the car, press the brake, and the car starts. So the car is, as you can see, the like, instrument cluster and the steering wheel, they're both the same. Now coming over here, you have a different style of navigation system. The climate control is also a different one. Over here, you get your auxiliary and the USB options over here. Over here, you get the traction control. This is also something different in this one. Over here, you get sports mode. Apart from that, the entire design of the dashboard, if you can see, is also different in this one. And one more thing, if you want to close the air, this is how you do it in this one. So if you turn it, the air is on and the air is off. Like the duct can be closed like this. One more feature, when you put the car in reverse, this is in this one, the mirror adjusts itself. This is also a feature that is available in the new one and was not there in the old one. Now when you come to the rear of the car, the space that you have, like leg space, the head space, it's all very comfortable. This is the same way it was in the old one as well, if you remember. And there was a Dorado Gold Altis hardtop that we reviewed earlier. That also had the similar space. And this rear seat can be reclined and folded if you need to. There is a lever. This is a feature in both the cars. And on your armrest, you have space for two cup holder space is there, and easily three people can fit in the back. Now the trunk space is the same in both the cars. This is a big size trunk, and you can get more space by folding the rear seats. If you want to see your rear tire and everything, this is all over here, as you can see. Yeah, you have a button over here. This button, you press this button to open and close the trunk. If you are outside the car but you have the key in your hand, you can open and close the trunk with this button as well. These are all the features and differences about these two cars. Now let's take the car for a drive to see how it drives. And I'll be driving one car just because they both drive the same, so I don't need to drive both the cars. I'll just drive one and that's the drive. Alright, so now we're driving this Altis Grande, the facelift model. The visibility is alright. If you remember, we did a review of the hardtop 1.8 Altis a couple of months back. So the visibility is more or less the same in both the cars. This car has traction control, this car has paddle shifters. Right now while I'm driving the car, I can see this instrument cluster is a little bit different. Like overall design philosophy of the instrument cluster is the same as the old one, but it is a little different in terms of the fonts and like this echo light. It is on the other side in this one. Coming to the availability of spares, you can easily find all the spares of this car. The fuel average right now is about 8.3 kilometer, that I can see on the instrument cluster. But overall average would be between 8 to 8.5, something like that, depending on how you drive and how well maintained your car is. The price, the new one costs somewhere around 2.6 million rupees, and while you're talking about the old one, the old will start something like 2 million and it'll take up from there. One more thing that I would like to mention over here is that the initial cars that came in 2014, they did not have automatic climate control or jackknife key or this instrument cluster, which Toyota calls as wow meter. Those cars did not have these. This was offered somewhere in 2016, early 2016. They did minor upgrades where they gave the jackknife key. You got this instrument cluster and you got the automatic climate control. The design is changed again in this one with the automatic climate control. Coming to the resale of the car, always in Corolla, people prefer the 1.3 liter or 1.6, like the smaller engine they can get. There is a conception that probably the bigger engines are heavier on fuel or something like that, but it's all about power to weight ratio. In my opinion, the bigger the engine, the better the car performs. So because of that, the resale does affect. The resale factor, if you're getting the car because of that, you will have a little bit difficulty selling a 1.8 compared to the 1.3 or 1.6 liter car. acceleration is good. The car comes with traction control, so the driver is stable. You have ABS brakes, you have electronic power steering, multimedia say. So the car is a very good package for 2.6 million rupees. You get a lot of car for the price. And availability of parts and everything, it's a Toyota, it's a local Toyota, so you get easily get all the parts, wherever any part that you are looking for, you can get all of those very easy.
So this was all about the review and comparison of this Toyota Corolla. To subscribe to our channel, you can click here. If you'd like to watch more videos, you can click here and over here. Please let us know in the comment section what you think about this kind of a review, and if you'd like me to do similar reviews in future. Till next time, bye.